Dame i gospodo, dobroveče, dobrodošli. Nakon upravo završenog sastanka izjave za javnost da će predsjednik vlade Crne Gore, gospodin Duško Marković i visoka predstavnica Evropske unije za spoljnu i bezbjednostnu politiku, gospođa Federica Mogherini. Predsjedniče Markoviću, izvolite.
Hvala, dame i gospodo. Zahvaljujem se visokoj predstavnici Evropske unije Federiki Mogherini na današnjoj posjeti Crnoj Gori, na prilici da razmijenimo mišljenje o aktuelnim pitanjima iz naše evropske agende, a posebno na njenoj posjeti Skupštini Crne Gore i obraćanja poslanicima. Saglasili smo se da Crna Gora dobro napreduje na svom evropskom i euroatlantskom putu i da je sve bliža ispunjavanju njenih strateških nacionalnih ciljeva. Analizirali smo pregovarački proces sa Evropskom unijom i konstatovali da on dinamično napreduje ka krajnjem cilju, a to je okončanje pregovaračkog procesa u mandatu ove vlade. Pitanje proširenja je važno za kredibilitet Evropske unije i za napredak Zapadnog Balkana i njegovu dugoročnu stabilnost. A uspjesi koje Crna Gora postiže na evropskom putu predstavljaju značajan podsticaj i za ostale zemlje Zapadnog Balkana. U tom kontekstu smatramo da dinamika napredovanja svake zemlje pojedinačno treba da zavisi od njenog učinka u pregovaračkom procesu, a prenio sam visokoj predstavnici da je Crna Gora i dalje spremna da bude od pomoći ostalim zemljama kandidatima kao promoter evropske politike na Zapadnom Balkanu. Takođe, razumijemo da unutrašnja situacija u pojedinim evropskim državama, izborni procesi koji slijede tokom ove godine snažno utiču na brzinu pregovaračkog procesa država kandidata, pa i Crne Gore. Razumijemo i poziciju Evropske komisije i ograničenja koja ima u donošenju odluka, s obzirom da usaglašena pozicija sa 27 zemalja članica u nekom pitanju nije dovoljna, ukoliko makar jedna država izrazi rezervu. Dakle, vladavina prava je naravno temelj na osnovu kojeg Crna Gora razvija i vodi ukupan pregovarački proces i zbog toga smo snažno koncentrisani na ispunjavanju obaveza iz poglavlja 23 i 24 i ispunjenju 83 privremena mjerila. Ostvareni napredak na ovom planu prepoznat je i u zadnjem izveštaju Evropske komisije o napretku. Također smo pomenuli i aktuelni bojkot opozicije. Želim da kažem da je on i za Crnu Goru neprihvatljiv. Neprihvatljiv je zbog toga što nije proevropski i zbog toga što nije demokratski. Vlada je sa svoje strane više poslala jasnu podršku proevropskoj poziciji da su njena vrata otvorena za predstavnike tih partija. Mi ne možemo više od toga da ponudimo u ovom trenutku i želimo da se zaista taj dijalog uspostavi na političkim principima, na pravilima političkog sistema i demokratije i da svi budemo u parlamentu i da u parlamentu vodimo dijalog o svim pitanjima koja su značajna za državu i njene građane. Na ultimatum da oni žele da se ponove oktobarski izbori i da na taj način stvorimo uslove za ulazak u parlament, jednostavno su neprehvatljivi jer bi to značilo poništenje političkog sistema i regularnost izbora koji su završeni u oktobru 2016. godine. Dakle, želim i ovom prilikom da ukažem i pozovem na političku odgovornost, na razum političkih lidera, da su naši politički interesi manje važni od državnih interesa i interesa građana, da naša evropska perspektiva je u takvoj mjeri ili u takvom, da kažemo, statusu koja omogućava građanima Crne Gore nove prilike, nove šanse za bolji život, veliku mogućnost da Crna Gora valorizuje svoje resurse u interesu svojih građana i da to političari moraju prihvatiti kao realnost i u odnosu na to se odrediti bez obzira na političke razlike koje imamo u ovom trenutku. Kada je u pitanju region, Crna Gora je u kontinuitetu posvećena regionalnoj saradnji, ima aktivnu ulogu izgradnji stabilnog i bezbjednog regiona kroz učešće u regionalnim organizacijama i inicijativama. Samo stabilnost u regionu Zapadnog Balkana nam daje prilike, nove prilike i nove šanse i ostvarenje naše euroatlantske i evropske agende. Zbog toga je neophodno da svi u regionu, prije svega političari, budu spremni i sposobni da o razlikama diskutuju, da razlike ne budu povod da se udaljavamo, a posebno da se konfrontiramo i na taj način činimo štetu ne samo našim državama, nego štetu i našim građanima. Dakle, Crna Gora će kao i do sada uraditi sve da dijalog na Zapadnom Balkanu bude osnovni temelj našeg političkog djelovanja i da očuvanje mira i stabilnosti na Zapadnom Balkanu je u stvari perspektiva, trajna perspektiva za njegov progres i kvalitet života. Dakle, nije samo obaveza Evropske unije, niti može biti samo obaveza Evropske unije da brine o miru i stabilnosti na Balkanu. To je obaveza nas koji se bavimo javnim poslom i politikom na Balkanu i Crna Gora će u tom smislu davati snažan doprinos. Dakle, kada se ne razumijemo, treba da razgovaramo, a ne kada se ne razumijemo, da se udaljavamo jedni u drugih. Crna Gora takođe, pored evropske agende, snažno radi na svojoj atlantskoj integraciji i evo želim sa zadovoljstvom, iako tu informaciju već imate, podijelim činjenicu da je danas Kanada ratifikovala protokol o članstvu i da su ostale još samo tri zemlje, Sjedinjene Američke Države, Španija i Holandija i očekujemo da u narednih par mjeseci se ratifikacije u tim zemljama završe i da će Crna Gora u maju na novom samitu, odnosno ovogodišnjem samitu NATO-a u Briselu biti nova 29. članica. To nije važno samo zbog Crne Gore, to je važno zbog regiona u cjelini, zbog njegove stabilnosti, a vjerujem i stabilnosti Evrope u cjelini. Još jednom na kraju zaista izražavam veliku zahvalnost i poštovanje za odluku da posjetite Crnu Goru, za vašu spremnost da obiđete cijeli region i da pošaljete poruke koje će, vjerujem, svi dobro razumijeti u regionu i na taj način dati novu šansu ili novu priliku Zapadnom Balkanu kada je u pitanju njena i evropska i euroatlantska integracija.
Predsjedniče, hvala. Gospođo Mogherini, izvolite.
It was really a pleasure for me to be back in a different capacity in Podgorica, and I start here out of my strong will and decision. I start here a visit to all the Western Balkan six. I start here because Montenegro is clearly the front runner in the EU integration process. And I start here a regional visit because in the European Union we know that there is not going to be any progress on the European Union integration path if it's not also accompanied by a strong regional integration or cooperation process. And on the other side, we know that giving a strong and credible EU perspective to each of the six represents the best basis for regional cooperation. The two things go together. And we have a strategic interest as Europeans, inside or outside of the Union, to make sure that this region that is in the heart of Europe finds the way to cooperate after just 20 years of the conflict. 20 years can be a long time, but can also be a very short time. And I think that if the Western Balkans are today a region that, with all the problems, still is a cooperative region, that is building together common economic projects, infrastructure projects, and is talking rather than fighting, this is thanks to the European Union perspective of the entire region. We are aware of that. This is in the interest of the citizens of Montenegro, for sure, of the Western Balkans, of the Balkans at large, of the European Union, and of the entire continent. This is why the message I'm bringing here, starting my visit here, is this, that the European Union door is open. Not only that, but that we want you to cross that door and enter. And that this is not a faraway dream, but this is a project on which Montenegro has done incredible steps, thanks to the determination of its leadership, thanks to a credible approach so far of the European Union, and that others can follow exactly the same path, and that we can finish the mandate of this European Commission and the term of the European institutions currently. We still have 2 years and a half, or a little bit more than that, reflecting not only of how will be the future of the European Union when we will be 27 after the Brexit, but also when we will have new member states, and we will be more than 27 and more than 28. This is part of the future of the European Union, and as we launch the reflection on the future of the European Union, me being here means that we reflect on this together with the countries that are working to enter the European Union, starting with Montenegro. So this is for sure a message of encouragement, of hope, but also a message of commitment, because we know very well that this needs, membership to the European Union needs hard work on your side, not to meet our conditions, but to meet the expectations of your people, because every step is a step that improves the lives of the people and the society and the infrastructure of the country. But this also requires commitment and credibility from our side, and I'm here also to tell you, not only personally, but on the name of the European institutions, Commission and Council together, I'm the only one lucky enough to represent both, that the European Union is committed to have new member states, to have the European Union integration process for Montenegro and for all the region as a credible and real perspective. So it's not a dream, it's not a vision, it's something that is happening and that will happen in the coming years if we manage to continue to work well together. And as I said, this is not out of charity, this is because we believe we share a common European interest in cooperation, economic growth, stability and security. Peace is not something you can give for granted. And economic growth, we learned it, is not something you can give for granted. These are the two features of the European Union, and we see a huge potential for the Balkans to be part of this big project. I was honored and pleased today not only to meet you, which is a great pleasure, and our conversation will continue in the evening, touching also on some aspects of our cooperation, on some common elements of interest, from economy to security. But also, I was pleased to meet the President, the Speaker of the Parliament, and to address the Parliament. I have been a national parliamentarian myself. It is deep in the European Union conviction, the fact that institutions are always to honor. They are the temple of democracy, and the Parliament is, by definition, the heart of our democracies. I was saddened that the opposition was not present today. I hoped for them to be present and have in that occasion an exchange with them. I am sure, I hope there will be other occasions in the future, and I hope that my message in the Parliament of trying to build space for cooperation, trying to return to the institutions, and this requires goodwill on the opposition side, but also on the government side, creates the conditions for this situation to evolve into a normal institutional situation. I think people of Montenegro expect their institutions to function and to face the problems we all know. Because it's true, Montenegro is the front runner. We have good news when it comes to Montenegro, but it's also true that the economic and social situation is difficult, not only in Montenegro, actually the economy here is going quite well, but it's a global trend, it's a European trend. And the challenges the society is facing, the challenges people are facing, require everybody to do their part of the work. So I hope that this situation can find a solution. It's not for the European Union to indicate solution. I always say we do not enter into the politics of countries, not even in the politics of our own member states. We relate to the institutions of the country and we strengthen institutions because we see institutions as the key element for participation, stability, and for delivering to our citizens. So I would like to thank you, Mr. Prime Minister, for the warm welcome and for the very fruitful exchanges we've had. But most of all, I would like to wish you, your government, the parliament, the entire parliament, the president, the authorities of the country, wisdom, determination, and vision. Some argue that vision should not be used in politics. I believe we need also vision, joined with determination and courage and consistency to lead the country towards the European Union, inside the European Union. And on our side, you will always find a partner to do that. Because this is important for the country, this is important for the European Union, this is also important for the region. I would like to take this opportunity to mention only one other thing, that the role that you're playing in the region is remarkable, and we will continue to work together for stability in the Balkans and for a better future for all of us. Thank you very much.
Želimo vam ugodnu noć.